how you G-A-T-A.
After defeating South Alabama this past Saturday for their first ever Sun Belt Conference win, Georgia Southern Eagles seem to be off to a good start. Their defensive line did great against the Jaguars, letting in only 6 points for the 28-6 final score. Football, a highly regarded and long-lasting tradition here at Georgia Southern, has taken a turn. Not only did the Eagles enter their inaugural year as a Sun Belt team, but they will also be playing in a newly renovated stadium. Behind me, you can see the 6,200 extra seats added to Paulson over the last summer. The $4.7 million expansion to Paulson Stadium now boasts over 25,000 seats, which the Eagles hope will allow them to break their 1989 record of over 25,700 attendees. Basketball season is just around the corner, and no one could be more excited for it to begin than Coach Byington and his team. The Eagles had a great run last year, making it to the Southern Conference semifinals for the first time since 2005. The Eagles are now getting ready to face off against brand new opponents as they step into their inaugural season as a Sun Belt team. I talked to Coach Byington and I asked him how the team has dealt with this transition.
Yeah, we're very excited about being.
Georgia Southern is ready for the men's soccer Sun Belt tournament to begin as the 2014 season comes to a close. All schools in the conference are arriving and they are excited that the ball has started to roll on Erk Field. It's no secret Georgia Southern's football team is going through one of their best seasons in the program's modern history. Last weekend, Navy snapped the Eagles' 7-game winning streak with a 52-19 final score. Despite the loss, Georgia Southern is one game away from winning a conference championship as they maintain a perfect record in league play. I talked to Coach Fritz about the Navy game and how the team is preparing going into their bye week for their last game against Monroe.
You know, obviously, you know, we didn't play as well as what we feel like we're capable of playing.
Georgia Southern's men's basketball team has been garnering lots of attention recently. Not only have the Eagles had an amazing start in their inaugural year as a Sun Belt team, but they have also brought the crowd back to Hanner Fieldhouse. With such a young team but great success so far, the Eagles look toward captain jersey number 5, Jelani Hewitt, to lead them into their first Sun Belt Conference championship.
The reason I decided to come here was my first coach that was here, Charlton Young. He was a Miami guy. You know, I'm from Fort Lauderdale, so we pretty much knew each other.
The 2014-2015 football season has been great to the Georgia Southern Eagles. Not only did the Eagles go undefeated in the conference, but they went on to win the Sun Belt Conference title. However, not everything was smooth sailing, as there were many who doubted the Eagles' capacity to get as far as they did. I talked to Coach Fritz about what his expectations are for the upcoming season.
Well, you know, we've got to find a way to get better. That's what I keep telling them.
I am Cesar Perez for Sun Belt on campus, Georgia Southern.
Be exaggerating when you say you're living life in the fast lane, moving at the speed of life and I can't slow down. Only got a gallon in the gas tank, but I'm almost at the finish line, so I can't stop now. I don't really know where I'm headed, just enjoying the ride. Don't go till I drop and ride till I die. Living life in the fast lane, to the metal. Life in the fast lane, to the metal.
The whole purpose of the 5-week training program was to show people that it's not about the quantity that you do, but about the quality of the work.
Once I got past that hump week, it got easier, and overall, I think it's been a good experience for me.
We did some anaerobic and aerobic exercises, trying to switch it up here and there to make sure that our body remains challenged.
5 weeks working with Cesar Perez, taught me the difference between good and bad fitness, proper techniques on certain lifts, and how my body responds to different stresses.
I've seen my face slim down a little bit and my stomach has gotten a little bit more toned. I can feel the improvement.
It was hard getting up at first and trying to, you know, hit the gym so early and getting our workout in every day of the week. But every accomplishment starts with a decision to try, and so that's what we were really trying to go for. That was our main goal.
Battle Beast Fitness, bred for battle.
But when you see success, when you're at the peak, you will realize that the extra mile made the difference. every accomplishment starts with a decision to try. I will not give up. I will see my goals through. I will make my visions a reality. I will make my goals a success. I will always give in my all rather than give in. I am a beast bred for battle, and I will win this war. You can't stop me.